Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all.
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on, from this moment, I have been blessed. I live only for your happiness and for your love. I'd give my last breath from this moment on. I give my hand to you with all my heart. I can't
some of you may remember Susie from the Puppy Project. 2 years have passed. Susie is now the mother of a new litter of North Star pups. The puppies have been carefully bred with both nature and nurture in mind. It is neither one nor the other, but an interplay of the two that matters the most. Their earliest attempts to communicate are quickly noticed and encouraged. The puppies have been surrounded by the love of children since their first breath. I save money by hiring staff who will work for sweet food and late-night television. The puppies will grow up to trust children, to regard them as leaders, and to seek their attention. This is Bailey, the most adventurous and lively of the pups. This is Buddy, the calmest and most self-possessed. Daphne and Piper, the most social and people-oriented. And Mika, the most playful. Puppies learn best within the context of play, and so they get plenty of it, both with each other, as well as my children. The equipment needed to train a puppy for a child with a developmental disability can be as inexpensive as an untied shoelace. And as priceless as a child's time, attention, and love.
You caught me! Oh, you have to catch me!
Don't let the simplicity of this technique blind you to its power. As the puppies develop, Piper has emerged as the most confident and intelligent of the group. Children with developmental disabilities are at risk for wandering into a world where danger may not be fully comprehended. Training a dog for them should include development of search and rescue skills. But our primary goal is to raise puppies who will give their children consistent attention and unconditional love. But my children are not the only children the puppies have come to know. This is Devin, a young boy with Down syndrome. He has been visiting the puppies since they were small with his parents and brother David.
This is David.
Oh, that's David.
Oh, yeah, like this. That's David.
Devin communicates with signs, although there is nothing wrong with his hearing. Many children find it easier to communicate with signs than the spoken word.
I think that Devin hears the dogs barking. Is that right? Do you hear them barking? Yeah, the dogs are outside barking.
Devin is both greatly intrigued as well as greatly frightened by dogs. Even these tiny puppies scare him. His brother David is quite the opposite. He is fearless and very motivated to get to know the pups. Devin needs a puppy with a very slow and gentle approach, while David will encourage the pup to be high energy and active. It takes a very intelligent puppy, or dog, to modify his behavior to two such extremes. We have chosen Piper to be the puppy for these two boys. They all take turns being frightened of each other.
Just figured out. out how to run, huh?
Through a training technique called targeting, the puppies have been taught to touch objects that we draw their attention to with their nose. Piper is given food when Devin approaches to make up for the reinforcement that Devin might inadvertently fail to give. But with or without food, Piper will quickly grow to love Devin. How could he help it? Children with Down syndrome tend to be blessed with a great deal of gentle charm.
Devin, do you see the dogs running? Dog?
Devin communicates with a mixture of signs and vocalizations. It can be frustrating for him to make himself understood. Watch him as he struggles to tell me something.
Would you like to see the puppies?
Devin is asking to see Madison, an assistance dog we received nearly a decade ago from Canine Companions for Independence to work with our son, Danny.
Big dog? Madison? Would you like to see Madison? Is that Madison? Want me to let him out? Okay. Here comes Maddie. There, Maddie.
Puppies are not the only creatures that captivate. I flew to Ohio with Piper for her to be raised by professional dog trainer Rachel Friedman. At North Star, we take great pride in the quality of our puppy-raising homes. Rachel and her family will train Piper for approximately 6 months, and placement will be made shortly thereafter. Piper chooses to sleep during this long and bumpy ride, her nose pressed to her stuffed duck that smells like home. Even at her young age, Piper shows excellent foundation behaviors. Her sits, downs, stays, and recalls are excellent. It was a very long journey for a very small pup. The life of a service dog is filled with great meaning and a bit of hardship. Fortunately for us, Rachel is also a mother. Her and her husband, Jay, share 3 girls, 2 dogs, and an assortment of rescued cats. Take Piper long to fit right in. An important part of Piper's training is to be heavily socialized to the children and the animals. Like any good parent, Piper must learn to bear the injustice of life with young children. Piper and Sophie relate under Rachel's careful supervision. Rachel is standing by to lend her young daughter her authority, and Piper will grow up with the understanding that tolerating children is all in a day's work. Oldest sister Zena takes the lead in puppy raising Piper. She does an excellent job, from training Piper to go down the slide to serving as a soft and user-friendly alarm clock. Piper learns quickly under Rachel's expert hand.
Okay.
And by the time she finally fits into her saddle, it is nearly time to go.
look, see?
Single pet him, Dev.
Yes. He's not going to bite you. He just wants to pet him.
Meanwhile, we continue to work with Devin, with Piper's brother, Buddy. I am training Buddy for two children on the autism spectrum using signs and verbal commands. North Star trainer Ron works with Devin's family. Kelsey provides a valuable bridge to transfer Buddy and later Piper's training to the younger children.
Very smart dog.
God, I can't get over it. It's really...
See, no, how pensive he is? He just...
That's good boy, Devin. You say sit.
Mild-tempered, and they're just very smart.
When the dog comes near you,
spent about 5 years
just
in the making trying to get the right genetics.
Stay still and say sit.
Because you've got to be really careful.
Good boy.
Right,
good for
right
you to remember that and tell Devin, because you can remind him of that, right? Good for you.
This is Janet, a speech therapist who works with Devin. She will be incorporating Buddy and later Piper into Devin's program to help develop verbal as well as signed language.
Good job, Buddy. Buddy. Oh, cold feet. How about?
Hi.
No.
Dog.
Hi, dog. Can you take the dog for a walk? Yes. Is there a leash for this dog? Do you think he likes to read books? I bet he does. What kind of books does a dog like?
Whoa. Oh, what a nice kiss.
What kind of books would he like? Do you think he'd like a book about a kitty? You really think so? Do dogs like kitties? Okay, well, let's find a kitty book then. Do you have one? Okay, you want to find it for me? All right, where is it? Where? Book.
Of course, would be sit. And for Devin, who's a little shy, I think that stop might be a good one, because I don't think you'll have a behavior problem with these lovely dogs, but to say stop, if he really doesn't want the dog to lick him or whatever, that
right.
would be a good idea.
Or from jumping as well.
Or from jumping.
I guess that would be the equivalent of no.
Right.
Yes, and no, he knows pretty well. He'll just go, oh.
Is that, what's the sign for no?
No is two fingers touching thumb.
Oh, okay.
No.
Good.
And then jumping. He knows jumping.
Good.
Because we have a favorite song called I Am Jumping Up and Down.
Okay, good.
So no jumping.
No jumping.
Perfect.
Yes. And Devin is beginning to pair signs, putting two and three together. Two mostly, but some two and three. Hey, Dev, can you say something for me? Can you say sit with your sign language? Sit. Can you do that? Oh, book. You want a book? Yeah, well, can we read a book after you tell me sit? Tell me sit. How about if I stand up? Want me to stand up?
Janet is very sensitive to notice where Devin's interests take him. The very best therapists follow the child's lead. The younger the child is, the more that this is true.
Yes, we're going to go find a kitty book because Devin thinks the dog would like it.
Hey, Jack. This is Jack, a 3-year-old boy on the autism spectrum with his mother, Amy. We chose Daphne to be paired with Jack and his big brother, Cal.
Stop, where's the doggies?
Autism is currently the fastest growing developmental disability, with $20 to $60 billion annual cost and $34 billion of future costs added per year. 90% of these costs are in adult services. The cost of treatment can be reduced by 2/3 with proper early diagnosis and creative intervention.
All aboard the puppy train!
We make several visits to Jack's home to discuss ways to enrich the placement. Mary Horn is a clicker trainer and owner of the training facility, Good Dog You. She will be working today with Daphne and Jack. Here, Mary demonstrates a technique that is designed to prevent Daphne from jumping up. Daphne does not get the treat unless all four paws are on the ground. The basics of clicker training are quite simple. You click and treat behavior that you find desirable. By using a clicker, Mary will specifically reinforce attention that Daphne pays to Jack. By focusing on positive rewards rather than punishment, Daphne is able to keep her lively and enthusiastic spirit.
Who is it? It's Daphne.
Now with the clicker, you and treat, and then eventually you try to limit or reduce the treats and just stay with the clicker instead of having to bring treats with you everywhere? Is that...
Actually, I don't do it that way. Okay. I eventually thin out the clicks so that I'll get five downs for one click or something like that, as opposed to... I think if you click and don't treat, over time you weaken the association because the click isn't intrinsically rewarding. It's just predictive of a real-life reward.
Oh, I see.
So, so in the beginning what I'll usually do is click intensively for behaviors as
right.
they happen, and then maybe we'll do, good, I'll give feedback, but I won't click that. Therefore, I won't treat it.
Okay.
So we'll do two furs and three furs, and so it might be sit, down, sit. Good, carry it out.
Any relationship is a dynamic. As Daphne pays more attention to Jack, so he notices her more as well. Training North Star dogs to shadow children with developmental disabilities continues even after placement is made. But even with the best of training, a North Star dog should be regarded as a safety net, not as a babysitter. They are only canine, after all, and it is important to remember they lack intellectual skills that are necessary to keep a child safe. But they have what it takes to help a child stay relaxed and happy. As Daphne takes a break, we gather to discuss ways to enrich this placement. Meetings at North Star are often held cross-legged on kitchen floors. This is Connie, a behavioral therapist who will be incorporating Daphne into Jack's existing program.
I think we're going to start off with pretend play, and we talked about this at our last clinic, is having Jack generalize playing with that stuffed dog and then to the real dog, because I think last time she was visiting, he was a little skeptical about her and how he was touching her, and you know, so I think he's just trying to make her out.
Okay.
Just having him play nicely with her and touch her nicely and not pull at her. And so I think now that she's getting a little bigger, I think he's going to be a little bit more comfortable with her.
Chris, Kelsey, and Daphne join Jack in his therapy session.
Jack, who loves you? Yay! Very nice.
What did he say?
Mommy. Oh. Who loves you?
Mama.
Yay!
Good for you.
That's right. What's your dog's name?
Daphne.
Oh. What's your dog's name? What's your dog's name?
There you
go. Good boy. Want to go play with Daphne? Let's bring Daphne. Oh, wow. Good job with her feet. Come here, Jack. We teach you to play ball with Daphne. Come sit down. Come sit down. Kisses. Kisses. Oh, she's giving you kisses, Jack. Nice, Jack. Oh, nice. Nice.
Daphne's tail.
There you go. That's nice playing with Daphne.
He's very gentle with her.
Yes.
Smile on his face.
Sit nicely, please. Thank you. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy.
Good boy. Good boy. This one we're working over throw and roll. Having Jack just
screaming. Yep. Sit down, please.
Sit down.
Thank you.
Roll bottle. Nice. You are so smart. Throw, Bob. Throw Bob. Jack, throw. There you go. Throw Bob.
Has been throwing, so, and just things that just could be potentially dangerous. Like he tried to throw a radio the other day. So we're trying to teach him that there's certain things that he can throw and other things he can't, just so he's not constantly stimming.
Okay.
So we're shaping up throwing to just balls. And then to something appropriate like the basketball hoop,
right,
or something like a game that he can throw something to. And you know, all the other things that he tries to throw, we give him the no,
right,
and we redirect that.
Come here. Throw! Yay! Throw! Woo! There you go, throw! Throw the ball! There you go!
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Throw the ball!
Throw! Slam dunk! Wow! Good job, Jack!
Whoa!
Okay, come here.
Throw it.
Come here, throw! Woo! Good boy! Throw the ball! Yay! That was a beautiful one! Okay, so Daphne, eat. Very nice! Say, Daphne, eat. Oh! We missed it. Daphne. Brush Daphne.
Very nice.
Nice boy.
Good boy.
Good for you.
Wow, look at you.
Good job.
You're such a big boy. Look at the doggy. Look, Jack, Jack. Look.
Just trying to get him to look at the task.
Bye.
Okay. What do you want?
I want tablets.
Okay. Okay, Dad wants to play with it.
Mm-hmm. Check, no climbing. Books.
Here, give me the book.
Give me book. A book. Book.
I'll give to Mama. Give to Mama.
The goal is to expand Jack's therapeutic program into his home life. To Daphne and Jack, this transition is easy.
Touch Daphne's nose.
Nose.
Where's Daphne's nose? Where's Daphne's nose?
It's nose.
Good boy.
Good boy.
You want to pet Daphne? You want to pet Daphne? Nice. Where's Daphne's ears? Daphne's ears? Ears. Ears. You want to pet Daphne's head? You want to pet Daphne? Daphne.
Daphne.
See ya.
Daphne.
Yeah.
See ya.
See ya.
Now you want to give Mika. Here, give Mika one of her pieces of
food. And say, good girl, Mika.
Say, good Mika, huh? We don't want her walking on you, though, right?
Mika is being placed with Jessie, a young girl with a learning disability,
okay,
and her big brother, Kenny.
Good,
although this placement is technically for Jessie, Kenny will be an important part of the placement as well. He has been there for his younger sister since the day she was born, and now Mika will be there for him as well. Mika has been playing with this very ball since her eyes first opened at 2 weeks of age.
Mika, show her the ball. Go like this and show her the ball.
She's like, no.
I don't think so.
Okay, I think Kenny needs a few minutes with her.
And it's really great to be flexible.
Oh, look at Mika turned around, sat right next to me.
She did. Good sit, Mika. Good girl, Mika.
Mika is being trained to help to motivate Jessie throughout her rigorous physical therapy program. Motivation is sometimes a problem for Jessie, and our goal today is to figure out how Mika can help. Physical therapist Maggie brainstorms with us to create ways we can use Mika as a tool for helping Jess to reach her goals.
So I was thinking that the one way that Mika could possibly be utilized is for Jessica to take her for regular walks on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
And wearing the little ankle weights that we have on her legs right now, which are only about half to three quarters of a pound each. But by doing that on a regular basis, that would work on developing her strength.
Okay.
The exercises that I do with Jessica involve stepping up and stepping down and squatting, doing a lot of leg bending. So I'm not really sure how we can utilize Mika to reinforce that. But maybe as we're working today, something will come up.
Okay.
Gotta go to work.
All right.
Maggie, right?
Come on down here.
While Jessie is hard at work, it is Mika's task to hold her sit. This is difficult for Mika, who is used to participating, but she quickly learns to listen to Tony.
Okay, and maybe we can just have Mika come and just sit right over here on the step while we do this exercise, and she can watch. Jessie, you want Mika to watch you do your exercises?
Mika, sit. Mika, sit. Sit.
Okay, come here. Come on down. Okay. All right, ready? Okay, one foot up.
Sit.
Okay, this one down. One, two, three, four, 10. Keep going. 11.
Sit down.
One more. 12, 13. 14, 15. Okay,
go
give Mika a pat. You did a good job.
Give Mika a hug. So Mika can give me kisses. Oh, give Mika a hug. Yes.
Okay, one thing that we could try to reinforce is that I really am trying to get Jessica to squat more than fall down
and sit.
Kind of sit or kneel on the floor. So maybe if when she comes to give Mika a little affection,
squat,
we can encourage her to stay on her feet and do this. Let me get this way, rather than falling down and doing this or this.
Come here. Come on over to Mika. And squat. No sitting. Just
don't
squat
sit.
Down.
No.
Just squat down.
That's
there
a girl.
You go.
That's a girl.
That's how you give Mika her loving, okay?
Come on. 13.
Whoa!
More. 14. And
one
where
more.
Are you going? 15. Good job.
Now you can come give Mika. Mika give you kisses too.
The biggest thing that I can see at this point in time
would be the walking. And
the walking and just reinforcing the squatting. And again, I mean, Tony, you know that even when I was working with you at home, I always tried to come up with things that would work into a regular routine.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
That was a natural thing that you could do anyway. So if that was part of her regime or part of her responsibility, Mika, that would be good. Does she help to feed Mika?
Yes.
Put the food in the bowl?
Yep. She does the food into the bowls. One of the other nice features has worked out really well is Mika likes the snow.
Uh-huh.
Jessie really didn't like to go out and just kind of play in the snow by herself. But like the last two snowstorms, we've bundled her up and just sent her outside with Mika and Kenny, of course. But she's out running in the snow, so it's lifting the legs up higher to get through the snow and stuff on. So you gotta work a little bit more.
And you have a hill in your yard, right? Isn't your yard a little sloped?
A little bit, not enough for like a snow.
Anything you can do in the snow, that's excellent for her.
Right.
Dog, or you going to the park and going up and You know, if you see a hill, Tony,
yeah,
make her go up and down. Yeah. And you can have her go up, you know, up and down, forwards and backwards, yeah, and sideways.
And that's what we were doing.
It's nice to have a friend when it's finally time to kick back.
Okay, you know what? I'll just, so that you guys know, the class is going to...
We have been continuing Buddy's training.
Go play. Go play, Buddy.
Play for Buddy means finding and following children. We have been training Buddy to develop search and rescue skills for Colby and Winnie, two children on the autism spectrum that he will soon go to live with. To prepare him for his important job, Buddy has been sleeping with pillowcases with Colby and Winnie's scent. Okay, Buddy is lavished with praise and attention whenever he finds or follows one of my children on my command.
Good boy, Buddy!
Buddy loves Christopher and Kelsey, but he regards me as his leader. I will transfer this leadership to Colby and Winnie's parents. He will live to please them and to adopt their concerns for Colby and Winnie as his own.
That's it. What a good boy bringing that back. That's a nice boy. Good for you. What an important dog. Good job. Good for you. Nice down. Good for you.
This is Mark and Valerie with their son, Colby. It is Colby that we are teaching how to play fetch, not Buddy. Colby is very intelligent, but he has limited speech. He will give Buddy his commands initially through the use of signs.
Down is like this. Yeah, just kind of a palm traveling downward. Yep.
All right, now Colby, look, turn around, look at the dog. Go like this, Colby. Go down. Ready? Nice.
Good.
Good job.
Excellent job, Colby.
Yeah.
Good for you, Colby.
Okay, now sit down.
Hi, Buddy. Hi, Buddy.
Hi.
Ready? Say.
Buddy.
Excellent job, Colby. Good for you. Good job.
What is that thing, Colby?
Buddy is paying close attention to Colby.
Oh, that's cute.
That is cute.
That's
good.
All right, Mr. Colby.
That's good.
That's good.
Where's Colby?
You know what, right there made me realize it's going to work, guys. Did you see his face?
Good job, Buddy. You are an important dog.
Buddy, come here. Sit. 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 Colby, sit. Very nice. See? Eat. Oh, good try, good try. Oh, that was good, that was good.
Okay, I want popcorn.
Connie is using this piece of equipment, called a dynamite, to teach Colby language. It is as powerful a learning tool as the substance it was named after.
I want popcorn.
Colby. Colby.
I want popcorn.
Very good. There you go. There you go.
that we belong together. Dress it out with the trappings of love. I'll be captivated. I'll hang from your lips instead of the gallows of heartache that hang from the bell. And I'll be your crying soldier. I'll be love suicide.
It is no accident that Buddy loves children. North Star dogs are surrounded by the love of children from the day they're born.
And rain falls, angry on the tin roof as we lie awake in my bed. And you're my survival, you're my living proof. My love is alive and not dead.
How are ya? How's Bailey sleeping?
Is Bailey sleeping? Where's Bailey? Can you see her? There she is.
Hi, Bailey.
She's not gonna nip at you. See, she just wants you to see you.
Oh, Bailey.
Let's try one more time.
Encouraging Gavin to see and understand the puppy's needs is the first goal of this placement.
Give her a little kiss tonight.
No child can develop social skills in a vacuum. Children with autism need to be surrounded by typical children who are atypically kind and willing to teach.
Whoa! Trying to roll.
Where are you going now?
Hey, Gavin.
Say cheese.
Say cheese, Gavin. Okay, I want to film you shooting a basket. Can you do that and I'll film you? Okay, I'll film you shooting a basket. Whoop, don't touch the camera, but I'll shoot you filming a basket with Chris. Then you could watch yourself playing basketball. There you go. Most children with autism are quite visual. Filming them is a good way to motivate them. Good job, Gavin.
You could see the pup. Okay. This pup's a little calmer for you, right?
Yes! It's a PlayStation!
I know. We're waiting to play with PlayStation.
Where's the puppy's ears?
There's your puppy's ears!
Very good, Gavin!
Do you know that Gavin's very gentle? I like how gentle you are with the little puppy.
Where's the puppy's little nose?
There's a puppy with a nose.
Good boy.
Where's Gavin's nose?
The puppy is learning about Gavin as well. I give Bailey lots of reassurance and an occasional treat so that she might interpret Gavin's loud voice and occasional rough patting as predictive of rewards.
Very good.
Hi, puppy.
Hi, can you give a kiss? Gavin, where's the puppy's nose?
There's a puppy's
nose. Where's Gavin's
nose? I don't scold the puppy for occasionally nipping at Gavin's fingers. She has no way of knowing whether Gavin is offering a treat. Within the next few months, Bailey will learn to inhibit the strength of her developing jaws and to develop a soft mouth with children.
That's right.
While Gavin gets his reward of a job well done with time spent on PlayStation, we pay attention to his brothers, Dylan and Nolan.
Tell him it's right there.
Yeah.
Siblings of children with special challenges are too often overlooked.
Okay, we have to go slow.
At North Star, we consider them unsung heroes.
You gotta wait.
Usually.
Nolan faced a steep learning curve on how to get the puppies to obey his commands.
Okay, he'll come back. There he comes.
The puppy's just playing with you.
Oh, Tigger wants your milk.
She's just a baby.
Stop doing my milk.
Stop doing my milk.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Getting Nolan and Bailey to respect each other's boundaries proved the most difficult part of this placement. After a 2-week trial period, Bailey came back, ready for some intensive training.
She's already sleeping.
Good girl.
Hey, no biting.
Bailey had no trouble taking commands from adults. It was children she needed to learn to listen to. We incorporated her training into the fabric of our day, reinforcing what we liked, ignoring what we didn't, and scolding when we had to. Training a young pup is best accomplished in frequent, short training sessions spaced throughout the day. Learning to stay was hardest for Bailey, who is active and lively by nature. After weeks of training, Bailey responded to both verbal and sign commands given by both Chris and Kelsey.
Stay, stay, stay. Good stay, good stay, good stay. Stay, stay. No, stay, stay. Good stay.
But the question remained whether Bailey could hold her training in a younger and livelier household. We brought Bailey home with fingers tightly crossed that she would remember what we taught her. Hi, Gavin.
Hi.
Hi, Nolan. It is every bit as important to train the children along with Bailey.
You did an excellent job. Always call Bailey when you get her attention first. If she's running away, don't say Bailey, Bailey, Bailey. Get Bailey to come, like, snap your fingers. Do that, or say, Bailey, here, or Bailey, come. And as soon as she comes, then say, Bailey, sit.
The puppy's going to sit for you now and not jump on you. All you have to say is, no, sit. If he jumps on you, okay?
Gavin, do you want to see Bailey?
You want to see Bailey?
Gavin seemed quite restless, as if there was something
Gavin,
on his mind.
Good sit.
Good
sit. Not right now.
Hey.
Good job. Can you tell Bailey that you missed her? You miss Bailey, huh?
Miss Bailey.
Yeah. Hi, Bailey. Hi, Bailey. We missed you. We missed you terribly. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. Yes, we did.
Gavin kept returning to the window, struggling to communicate something to us.
That's it, Bailey. That's it.
Sit.
Bailey.
Sit.
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 Nolan tries hard to give Bailey commands. Bailey's trying equally hard to obey them. Siblings of children with special challenges should be recognized and supported for the important job that they do.
Bailey, come.
Louder.
Louder.
Bailey, come.
Do little kissy noises.
Okay, say sit.
Sit.
Bailey.
Bailey.
Give it your toy when she sits.
Sit.
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 Sit. No, Bailey, here. Here.
Sit.
Yay, now give it
the
toy.
Give it the toy.
Good sit.
Bailey.
Good sit.
Good, good Bailey. Yeah, you did it.
Yeah, yeah.
You did it.
As we watch the action without sound, I invite you to see how tired Gavin is getting. Children with autism are easily overwhelmed by too much stimuli. It is very important to pay attention to their signals so that we can notice what they might have trouble communicating.
Call her name.
Name is Bailey.
Tell her to sit.
Sit.
It is best to end on a positive note.
Yay. You did it!
Gavin didn't like the camera or the plans I'd had to interview his mother that day.
Mom came and picked Bailey up with her crate and her dog dishes, and they left. And my babysitter informed me that for the next 20 minutes after Ron had left, Gavin threw himself on the floor in front of the door, cried for Bailey to come back. I'm getting choked up thinking about it. Bailey, no goodbye. He was crying. She had to bring him. You want to come over here and join me?
He hovered in the doorway, struggling to get our attention. In retrospect, he was trying to tell us of his own plans, but we had trouble understanding them. As usual, it was the children that led the way. But then finally, we listened. We let Gavin rule this day.
Every day is so wonderful, and suddenly it's hard to breathe. Now and then I get insecure from all the pain. I'm so ashamed.
Get on, and there were other kids on. They would join him. He would get off.
And so he's participating.
He's participating right now.
Okay.
This is his way of celebrating.
So it's like a shorthand to friendship.
I absolutely think so.
Wow.
This is his way of saying thank you.